This is what the canine condition should look like for every dog, but it doesn't. Why are there so many abandoned, abused, and neglected dogs all over this country?
Is it common for people to chain their dogs out here and leave them outside?
For fighting dogs, they tighten their collars up and it's supposed to make their necks stronger.
This is her chain. That was around her neck when we got her. And so she got her name Raspy because it damaged her vocal cords.
She showed us the puppy room. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. There's at least 30 puppies in the puppy room.
The kennels outside are all the mom and dad dogs. She doesn't sell those. They're out in the hot sun.
There's no covers on the kennel.
This is a huge, inhumane, immoral industry in this country.
We do need to fix our laws and legislation and make it mandatory that these pet stores adopt animals out rather than, you know, getting them from backyard breeders.
Law enforcement won't come out. They just say, shoot the dog.
They will tell people just to go ahead and shoot the dog.
These sentient beings didn't ask to be put in these conditions. They suffer and they die in silence. It's really troubling because it's all at the hands of humankind. We went to several shelters in Georgia, Pennsylvania, New York, New Jersey, California, Arizona, Illinois. They were all full.
The shelter, it's a very scary place for dogs. The puppies that are here, they should be in a home.
Oh, Mommy, I wish I could take you for an angel face, I really do.
But we are a high-kill shelter. We don't want to be, but we're small.
I'm jumping into this journey saying, let's try and save dogs.
Is that videotaping or just
not right now?
And then bam, I just get hit with all this. Owner surrenders, kill day, bait dogs. What does that even mean?
Where's the dog fighting house?
That's that house right there.
And people all around you don't say anything?
They had busted a fight ring in the area of where she was found. And part of her face is ripped off. She has scars all around her neck. I walked over and I looked at her. And I said, I'm not going to be able to love her. So almost as soon as I got her out, I fell in love with her.
I just saw a dog that was so wounded, that just needed somebody to love her, needed somebody to give her a chance because she had been treated so wrong.
Is it less evil? Is it, no big deal because it's just a dog? No. And what does that say about humans, then, that are doing this?
There is a direct link. Crimes against animals always moves to people.
It's a constant battle between good and evil. So the good, I believe, will always win.
This series is about getting to the solutions. We will focus on the people and programs taking action across the country to improve the canine condition.
As we get them out of the high-kill South and get them into the no-kill North,
I decided I was going to stop this at the start, so I came up with the bright idea that I was going to spay all of Megan.
We take dogs that are critically injured and require extensive medical care.
We have search and rescue dogs, as certified crime scene dogs, therapy dogs.
A lot of times people are like, well, if I donate to the Humane Society, where's my money going?
Yeah,
this is one of the places it's going.
Because they'll go to really good homes.
They have puppies, they have, what are you looking for? Guarantee there's a rescue or a shelter near you that has exactly what you're looking for.
There's so many things that you can do besides adopting or fostering. Donating things as small as paper towels, bleach, food, toys. Volunteer your time.
If you really believe in something and you know that you can make a difference, you are not alone.